Hello, this is Broyar, and welcome back to another episode of our Let's Play for Farming Simulator 22 as we continue our tribute run here. And we're just getting our cotton harvester set up over here to start getting our yearly cotton harvest going. Still very early in the day, 8:04, just finished fast forwarding a little bit ago. Picked up the cotton harvester, and it's still kind of a little bit dark out there. All right, while we're getting that rolling, let me do some checking on everything else. Make sure there's nothing else we needed to do elsewhere at the moment. Trying to remember where we left off. Oh, one thing we left off on. Well, left off on that. I haven't spoken about on this series yet. I talked about it on my other playthroughs. Is that I do have a few mods installed that are more along the quality of life side of things, I guess. As you can see, one of them in the top kind of right-ish part of the screen, it says we have zero active contracts at the moment. I have a mod that's going to help us track contracts, tell us what the percentage is completed, stuff like that. So that's just one mod. A couple other mods that I have that are just quality life. I have one that will calculate the field sizes for us. I've had a spreadsheet up for a while. Well, this one actually helps calculate those field sizes. You know, a little bit easier just within game without me having to pull up the spreadsheet all the time. So that is, I thought, pretty convenient. The other ones that also, it also obviously shows fertilizer, manure, even seed usage and stuff like that. So that's kind of useful. What else do I have? I have a mod that allows me to set prices that we're watching. So that way I don't have to keep going to that screen all the time. I can just set a price that I'm like, hey, if it gets above this mark, let me know. And we'll go ahead and, you know, sell from there. So, in fact, one thing I want to do real quick. Let me get this guy resituated. I do want to get, like, things like the soybeans and the cotton kind of listed there. So, for example, soybeans, we expect the price to be, you know, as high as $12.46. At least that's what we've seen in our recent time. And let's say I'm probably going to set it to about 95% of that mark, just so if it gets above that, I'll know that it's a good time to sell. So 1246. We're looking at, I don't know, 11, we'll say 1180. Just give it a nice rounded number of sorts. So we'll go to the soybeans, and I'll come over here, and I'll just say, whatever, just set to the highest. We'll just bump it up. To that 1180 mark. We'll hit okay on that. The other one we want to check, obviously, is the clothes. So, did I miss it? Nope, there it is. We've seen it at 10,124. So, 10,124 times 0.95. So, anything above like 9,600, we'll say, 9,615 maybe, would be within that range that we'd be okay with selling. I'm going to go ahead and dismiss you and get you to do a little bit of a header over here as well. Actually, we'll call it 9620. I think that'll be all right. So close. Come on, game. I think the game has had a hiccup for a second there. We are a long ways away from the highest right now. And then you gotta go up by 100 number, although obviously most of the products don't go up that high, so 10 should be sufficient, but it just happens to be closest. Is it the highest? It is the highest, isn't it? I think it is. I mean, I could have waited until it got further along and it would have been easier to say, hey, grab the highest price now, but I'll just go ahead and get it plugged in so I don't have to think about it anymore. 9620, it looks good to me. All right, so both of those are set. There's only two we care about right now, but if we get above those numbers, we'll know to start looking at the prices. Let me get you set up over here once you're done here in a second. get you doing the verticals now, or I guess technically horizontal if you look at the map. All right, while you're doing that, any other mods I wanted to show? I've got, like, the dirt mod that I had back in FS19, where the dirt shows up a little bit, you know, more accurately on the vehicles. So obviously that's not going to affect gameplay or anything. That's not even a quality of life. That's just a... It looks a little cooler. I have field info. So if we look at the info on the fields, we can actually see the potential harvest quantity, for example. Is it 14,894 liters, so it's pretty good. Potential yield is 0.91 tons per acre, and we've got basically 3.75 acres of actual usable area here. So thought that was kind of cool to have that extra field info. Seemed like a nice little extra bit. I think that's basically everything I've grabbed. Just again, just small little info. Most of it's info. Most of it's information about contracts, information about prices, information about land. Most of it is just information that I could find anywhere else, but it's just nice to have it all in one spot. Anything that we need to do right now? I mean, obviously, we're waiting on any sort of planting, so we're not doing any of that right now. So honestly, this tractor right here, the only thing you need to do is go grab us the trailer for picking up stuff here in a minute. In fact, we'll go ahead and grab that now, because we might as well. Probably should repair this tractor up a bit too. Assume we're okay on the clothes output. Yep. It's a little bit full. Obviously, it must have full storage over there because it's not actually spit out that 1,000 liters there, but we should be okay for now. I'll drive over there and load up the trailer here in a bit. Let's get this tractor repaired up. It's $46,000 to repaint you. Whew. That is a lot of repainting needs to be done. That's half the price of the vehicle right there. Really? I'm pretty sure I had that one right on the spot. Stop telling me that it's there if it's not there. I don't think we'll need this until the other side, right? That's what we did last time. I'll just put it here at the end of the road. We're ready to zip over, and we'll go grab the clothes real quick. All right, there we go. I'm ready to get some more clothes out soon. Anything on the used market that we cared about? I mean, there's some halfway decent tractors, but nothing we need right this second. I mean, that is also very nice as well. 20,000 bucks for a very large harrow. And we can even make it mega large for not that much more. That's actually really nice. If I wasn't using the John Deere seeder or planter, I might consider that. But since we want to continue to use the John Deere planter, I think we'll just stick without that because we don't need the cultivator for that. And then what about contracts? Anything on the contract side that we care about? There is a harvesting job for corn. Well, that does not really help us. A couple plowing jobs that we could probably work on, because it's going to take us a little while to get the cotton harvester, right? So we've got time to do something. Probably not the baling. Probably, I mean, the plowing one might not be bad, that's not a very good plow though, right? That's the small one, isn't it? And that's a field, that's a big field for such a small plow. It's 69, right? Oh no, 69 is the awkward one. Never mind. I was thinking it was 68. I don't know, 10,000 bucks just to get somebody to go do something for a bit. Probably not the worst idea in the world. Also got the fertilizing job. That wouldn't be bad either. Yeah, why not? We'll grab this one. We'll borrow the items from that one. We will not borrow the items from this one. I think I'm going to go ahead and fertilize this as well, though, because we've got a tractor that's available to do some stuff. Just have something else to do while we're kind of waiting on the cotton to get done. Or while we're doing the cotton, if I decide to tab back over there and do some of that myself. Only thing I would add to that contract screen would be kind of what type of contract it is, maybe. And I don't think that's already listed in there anywhere. I don't remember the hotkey to change that. There's a way to change that. Let me see if it's on here. Alt M. Okay, so there's a way just to make a percentage, which doesn't really matter to me, honestly. If it showed the actual like type of contract, that'd be fine. Some fertilizer. Right, that is correct. Fertilizing. Yes. What is this we have over here? I can't see in the light. Come on. That is fertilizer and that is fertilizer. Okay, so we're good here. All right, should be enough to get field 11 done at least. All right, let me let you drive up there. Yeah, that is a tiny plow for the size of field that we're going to be doing, but like I said, we got other stuff to do right now anyway, so might as well have something running. Why are you stuck? Like, you're not even facing the right direction. That's so strange. Oh, did a... No, car didn't hit you. What is your problem, dude? Why are you stuck going the wrong direction? Okay. Do you know how to get there now? Seems like you're okay for the moment. This is going to take forever on this field, I think. Deeny Diny Blow. Well, I'll get it done. Or I'll figure something else out. All right, get you rolling. Who else? I guess we have enough space for one more contract. If there's another decent one that's not a bailing contract, because I'm trying to avoid those. Cultivating contract. And we can go through a couple of these cultivating contracts, make a few thousand bucks by leasing this larger cultivator and then going through the rest of them. And if we did all these that are like $1,000 and higher, wouldn't be that bad. It wouldn't take that long. It's actually not a terrible idea. So let's borrow items from you. But we can't do these. We can't do these like that because I would need to have a free spot, which I guess we'll have a free spot once we finish the fertilizing. So yeah, why not? We'll borrow the items from here. Oh, is there not a wait for this one? Does not appear to be. So your field is field 9. Oh yeah, we're already third of the way done with field 11. And a whole 3% done with field 69. That one's gonna take forever. What line is this other awkwardly shaped one over here? Oh no, I'm sorry, that's 10. 9 is the one above that one. Okay, that one, 9's not as bad. In fact, I think 9 is mostly rectangular, except a little bit at the top, right? Looks like it. A little bit of a curve, I guess. Still, it's not as bad as... not quite as bad as 10. All right, get these done. If nothing else, these contracts will help pay for the maintenance on our tractor, which was quite a bit. All right, you're cruising along just fine. Could knock out field 2 over there. It's very, very close, obviously, once we finish this one. All right, you are almost done, my friend. What was the yield it said? We can't see it here. We have to see it over here, maybe. 14.945, I think it said at the highest, something like that. We'll see how accurate it was. Yeah, 14.760, not bad. I mean, that was just obviously an estimate based off that one spot's fertilization levels and things like that. A little bit of fluctuation, I think, across the thing, but yeah, not bad. Probably gonna have to take over the cotton harvesting a bit here in just a moment because it's just not very efficient, and we might hit that hour mark if I don't help out a little bit. The turning, it's not as efficient on turning and stuff. I also have a GPS mod installed, but if I understand it correctly, you have to actually buy the equipment or lease the equipment with the GPS attached to it. You can't just do it on any vehicle, so can't do it right now, as far as I can tell. We'll have to wait till we actually have a vehicle that has GPS available for it. Mostly that's just a way to kind of drive straight lines. We're not really going to like map out fields or anything like that. I don't even know if you can. You might be able to. But at the very least, we just want to be able to drive straighter lines and things like that. I can get all this in one, can't I? Yeah. All right, let's get you rolling. I need to go check on field. Oh, you're just confused right now. All right, let's check on field 11. You can't really see what you're doing. I'll have to check this. Actually, not that much. There we go. That one's done. Pretty easy one for almost $4,000. We will go ahead and grab this other one down here. Because why not? It is close. Field two. We'll knock this one out ourselves. I'm actually going to go ahead and put a cut in there. When we come back, we'll keep working on the cut and keep working on these contracts. But I do appreciate you guys watching. May God bless you, and I hope you join me again next time. Thank you, and goodbye. I wanted to give a special shout-out to the following channel members. Thank you so much for supporting the channel.